at the airport right now. I am going to somewhere really random for Labor Day weekend. Dallas. Mom is there with me, but she has no makeup on, so she's being a little bit shy. So we're about to go through the TSA check-in point. Gotta take my shoes off. And then they have like a bar in there. Probably go to the bar and get a couple drinks. Yay! Guys, I have made it into the LAX Alaska Airlines terminal. We have found our gate. We're like 3 hours early, I think. I don't even know what time it is. But our flight leaves like at 5:25 in the evening. I took a half a day at work today. I didn't work the whole day, so that was exciting. So yeah, we're just going to Dallas for no specific reason, just because I just picked it for the Labor Day weekend for shits and giggles. So we'll see how that goes. They have like a haunted town. It's called Mineral Wells. Like Ghost Adventures went there. I don't know if you guys watch Ghost Adventures with Zach and Aaron. But now me and Mom are gonna go to the bar, say hi. Hi. Oh my gosh. Hey guys, I am now at the Golden Road Bar and restaurant. Not very big in here, but it's pretty crowded because it's Labor Day weekend, so everybody's out here traveling, and so it's really packed in here. This is the same place that me and Dulce came to when we went to Vegas. So I got me a little burger. Me and Mom split it. She's already done with her. She ate her burger and her fries. I guess she was really hungry. And then we got a drink. Pretty good, I like it. I'm a margarita connoisseur and I approve of this margarita. The burger is really good too. I just chose to eat my fries first. So our flight has been delayed, unfortunately. So we're here for another hour more than expected. So we're super, super early, which is a good thing. Yay. Okay guys, I'm at my second bar. And I got a double. Yay. It's gonna be the fastest plane ride ever. Okay, hi vlog. I'm in the women's restroom and our flight is boarding now. So just came to the restroom for a quick touch up, a little pee break, and now we're on our way. Let's go. So I felt like I needed to use the restroom. So I went to the restroom, but nothing happened. So like, I just hope that once I get on the plane, all is good, you know? I think I'm just like nervous a little bit because it's a 3 hour flight. And I don't remember taking a 3 hour flight ever in my lifetime, so kind of nervous, but we'll see how it goes. Wish me luck. Hey guys, so I'm on the plane. There's apparently no TVs in here. So I should have got a magazine before I came on. We're gonna have some good conversations for these 3 hours.
We're coach ducks. That's right.
Let us learn our safety, ladies and gentlemen. Take care. Seatbelts, got that. Got that. Brace position. Okay.
2 hours, 37 minutes over to Dallas, 33,000 feet, and there will be a few bumps. I'll do my best to negotiate with Mother Nature. Apologize about the delay. As you can guess, Texas thunderstorms during the summer does add a little bit of fun to the afternoon, so this aircraft was just held up in Dallas. Now we're heading back. We're anticipating a mostly smooth ride as we get close to Dallas, but as always, the possibility there could be a few bumps in there. Definitely appreciate your patience in joining us this afternoon. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride.
Cause all
Okay guys, after 3 hours, we have landed in Dallas at the Love Field Airport.
And it's after midnight.
It's after midnight out here. LA time is 10:30, but out here it's like 2 hours ahead. So it's 12 midnight. And that flight was so boring because they didn't have like any TVs on the flight or anything. So it was just like dead silence the whole way. Kind of rough. Our butts are hurting from sitting for so long. But here we are. Hey. Okay guys, it is now Saturday evening and today we have two concerts to go to. We have Hiroshima, which is like a Japanese jazz band. They have a jazz festival here this weekend, so they're one of their performers there, and their set starts at 6 and it's like 5:45 now. But you know, they artists are always late to their sets or their concerts, so I'm sure we'll leave just in time. After that, we're going to Billy Bob's, which is like a big honky-tonk club, and it's supposedly it's like really big, and they have like all these different areas and a lot of bars in there. They have bull riding in there. So I'm looking forward to that. It's maybe about 20 minutes away from downtown. Sorry I didn't video or vlog earlier because we came in really late last night from our flight, which was delayed because they had a storm here in Dallas. They had a lot of rain, so flights got delayed. And so our flight was supposed to leave LA at 5:30. It wound up leaving like at 6:15 or 6:20 or something. And then we landed here at, I don't know, maybe like 12:30. So earlier, we woke up super late. Didn't intend on doing that. Like I had a itinerary and everything with all my planned out activities, but unfortunately that didn't happen. We woke up at like 11. Well, you know, we woke up and then we just hung out, watched TV a little bit. Just, I guess we were just tired and stressed out. But then we finally woke up and we went to a friend's house here in Dallas. And they had like cows and horses and everything. So that was really fun. If I can, I'll insert some pictures. But now we're back from there. And now is our concert. So I'm wearing a dress. There is also a shooting in Dallas. Not Dallas, but Texas. Not too long ago. I got the alert on my phone saying that there was a shooting in Dallas. I mean in Texas somewhere. So I don't know how far that is from here, but it's kind of scary. 13 people died, so unfortunately, sad, sad, sad. Officially made it to our seats at the jazz festival. So Hiroshima just finished. They did really well. I got bit by a spider, by the way, so I don't know what that is. I'm not dying yet, so that's good. So we just left Hiroshima and now we're on our way to go change. I'm gonna put some jeans on and a different top, so because it's like at a honky-tonk bar. So on our way to go see Los Lonely Boys, I'll keep you guys updated. Hey guys, look at my rental. You can't see it, it's too dark. But it is a Hyundai.
It's nice.
What is it called? Hyundai Yeah, I forget. But it's like a crossover type. I like it. Very cool. Here we are. We have arrived at Billy Bob's for our concert. Fashionably late. Sunday morning. Last night was really fun. We went to Billy Bob's. We went to see Los Lonely Boys. They did really, really good. We played a game of pool. We had a couple drinks. I really love Billy Bob's. It's so big in there. There's like all these different bars in there. There's like one main stage and like a little side stage. But it was pretty, really cool. And then there's another, like it's like in an old town area kind of. So there's another club located like just around the corner from it, and there was like a long old line out there at 2 or 3 in the morning, so I don't know what was going on. But now we are on our way to Mineral Wells. They have a haunted, abandoned hotel there. So I'm gonna go see what it's about. It's an hour away, so we are in the car and on our way. Okay guys, we have made it to Mineral Wells. It is a quaint little tiny town. And it's pretty cool. Like, it's neat, all these old buildings. We passed one building that we thought was the famous Haunted Baker Hotel, but no, I think this is it. So there's two old buildings that are really nice. Well, I wanted a trespass, but I just saw a police officer, so.
What is that? It's over there, haunted house.
What does it say?
Haunted house.
An apartment building right
there. It has to have been. Okay guys, so I'm here in Mineral Wells, Texas, and I've come across a haunted house with a ghost in the window. He's chilling. He's enjoying the lovely day today. Hey guys, I am in Mineral Wells, Texas, and I'm at the famous Mineral Wells Water Company. But it's Sunday, so I think they're closed already. But look at this cool archway. My spider bite is still there.
Remember what Zach was talking about, sweetheart?
What?
This.
The crazy water. I watched Ghost Adventures and they were saying that the spring water here is like makes you crazy. Wishing well. Should I make a wish? Have you guys ever seen Snow White? Wait, that doesn't even look like a wishing well. Huh? Never mind, there's no pit in the bottom of it for me to sing like Snow White. And guess what? There is the Baker Hotel. It is so awesome. Unfortunately, it's all fenced off. Because I guess maybe they get too many trespassers. It looks beautiful though. They're supposed to renovate it. So currently they have plans to renovate the Baker Hotel. It doesn't look like they've started at all. I hope that it gets done soon so we could come back and check it out and actually go inside. I really wanted to do some ghost hunting, but there's a police station not too far from here and I've already seen some cops patrolling the area. So I also read before I got here that trespassing fees could be quite expensive here, so yeah, I'm not gonna try it. So in its heyday, it attracted all kinds of celebrities and people from everywhere because it was said that the mineral water here in Mineral Wells, Texas, had magical powers that could heal you. And so people would come from everywhere. And like that's like a little balcony that they had back in its heyday. There's also that, but like that was like a little ballroom up there. I'm trying to see if I could see like any ghosts hanging out in the window or anything, but nah. This is a little bit of the old town, Mineral Wells. Just a lot of old buildings, but they're all abandoned. So there's like nothing in any of these buildings. So it's not that exciting, but but the architecture is really neat. There goes Mother. Look at how pretty this is, guys. This is amazing. Once they renovate it, it is going to be so beautiful. Like, they could have a little restaurant in there, have little tables out there. After the discovery of the mineral water's healing powder, properties to him. What the heck? Mineral wells began to boom as travelers and health enthusiasts flooded into it to try the crazy water. This brought a wave of new business owners that wanted to dip their toes in the mineral water business. For several years in the 1920s, Mineral Wells was known as the South's greatest health resort. Wow, I need to try some of this crazy water. We stopped at the Mineral Wells State Park. I'm not sure what to expect, but hey, we're here in the area, so you might as well stop, check it out. There's another park that I wanted to visit. It's called the Brazos River or something, but it's located like 28 more miles from where we are, and we're already a little further from Dallas. So maybe we'll just save that for the next trip. There's a lot of bugs out here. I hit a lot of butterflies, unfortunately, on the highway. There's all kinds of critters out here. We have now ventured into Mineral Wells State Park. It is very hot out here and humid. Don't know how long we're gonna last out here, but hopefully we don't get lost. All right, that's the update. Currently about 10 minutes into our hike. We turned around. It's too hot. Way too hot. We came across like a mile marker thing. Oh, this is where the spider web is, remember? And it said like it gave you options for 4 miles or 6 miles. And we're like, neither. Let's just turn back around. I'm dripping sweat right now. It is so hot. So remember I was telling you guys about the crazy water, the mineral water? They have it here at this general store at Mineral Wells Park, State Park, because the other mineral water company was closed. They have it here.
So this is good. Is this four?
You want to get the big ones? I'm not going to drink it. Okay, guys, we have our mineral water. Here it is. And we got the strongest one. They have number one, level two, three, and four. And we got level four, which is going to be the craziest, crazy water ever. And it's going to taste disgusting.
Cheers.
Gotta taste it at the same time. Ready?
Ready.
It don't taste bad.
It's different. I could taste something.
Honestly, don't taste anything. It just tastes like regular water, except for the at the end, like there's the aftertaste of like...
It reminds me of something. It reminds me of something like...
It's refreshing. It just tastes like regular water to me, except for at the end there's like a...
Almost, it's metal. It tastes like Alka-Seltzer, kind of, but it, without the sparkle. You don't have Alka-Seltzer. I think that's what it kind of reminds me. Like Alka-Seltzer without the fizz.
I don't know. I can't explain it, but it's not bad. So, it's just like water.
It's if it makes us crazy.
Oh no! I'm crazy! All right. I know I've been terrible at vlogging this whole experience, but I've had such a good time. Today we went to Mineral Wells and we did a little short hike, and then we went to like the Lake of Mineral Wells, which wasn't too far from the, it wasn't the same park, so it wasn't far at all. So we just took a little drive down to the river or the lake, and then they had a little general store that was selling those mineral waters, and we had some mineral water, and it was okay. It tasted the same as all the other like waters and everything. It wasn't anything too special. So then from there, we went to the Park City Mall. I believe it's called Park City Center or something in Dallas. And it was really busy. There's a lot of traffic in that area. And the mall was like super crowded. So if you're from California, it's equivalent to the South Coast Plaza. South Coast Plaza in California is in Orange County. And they have like all the hoity-toity stores. Saks Fifth Avenue, Neiman Marcus, and all the others. At Barney's, and I can't remember anything else. Louis Vuitton, Chanel, all that kind of stuff. So here in Texas, they have the Park City Center. It's better just to wait till we get home and shop, I guess. And then from there, we came back because we had a dinner reservation for a Mexican restaurant out here. It's called Javier's. There is a really popular Javier's in California, a food chain called Javier's, which is my personal favorite. They have the best margaritas, but the one in Texas here is not the same Javier's. It was in uptown, what was it called? Knox, Uptown Knox something, I believe, in Dallas. They had really good food. It was a little bit more intimate. A really good bar, really good drinks. After that, we took a little tour around Highland Park, I believe that's what it's called, Highland Park, Dallas, and it's like the uppity Beverly Hills type area of Dallas, and that was really, really nice. They had lovely homes. I really love that area. It was really nice. The houses are amazing. And then from there, we went on a little tour of something, Bronson Arts or something with a B. Bishop Arts. There we go. Bishop Arts District. So they had like all these little bars and art, and they did have like old architecture buildings, but just renovated type of thing. And it was really nice. I enjoyed that. We got off and walked a little bit, but it was a little late, so not everything was open. We also visited the theater that they caught Oswald at. Oswald is the guy that shot JFK. Here in Dallas, we got to see that intersection of where it happened, where JFK got shot by Oswald. The street has an actual X marker on it where JFK got shot. And then, of course, like the grassy knoll that is right next to it alongside the street, you'll recognize it if you've seen any photos that of the JFK assassination site, where people were standing and where people were witnessing this tragic event.
Okay, second window from the top there looks like it's open.
Okay, thank you.
This is a step-by-step map showing you where you are. The great souvenirs collectors, they sell for only $5.
Okay, thank you. This is here in Dallas where JFK got shot. This is the building that Oswald is in. He was on the sixth floor, so one. And JFK's motorcade came from that away and then turned down that away.
So there's a marker in the middle of the street to indicate where JFK was in his motorcade when they got shot.
X marks the spot.
Since I am also a tourist at Billy Bob's, I got me a good old Billy Bob's Texas t-shirt. Any of you guys come to Texas, y'all gotta get you a Billy Bob's Texas Fort Worth, Texas shirt. That's all yellow in Texas-y. Woo! Billy Bob's was amazing. It's like one of the biggest honky tonks ever. They had the main stage and then they had a little side stage. We went to go see Los Lonely Boys. It was sold out. We had really good seats right in the front. And there was people standing along the sides because the show was sold out, so you could have the choice of standing alongside the stage area. I don't know, but it was just really crowded is my point that I'm trying to make. Like, it was just sold out and everybody loved it. They did such a good job. But after the show ended, we hung around until the bar closed at 2 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock. I'm not even sure. So all in all, we've had a good trip to Dallas. I'm so sorry I didn't vlog more like I was supposed to, but I was just really enjoying being in the moment of experiencing the state of Texas and the city of Dallas. If I ever come to Texas again, I would like to go to Austin, Texas, because I've heard that that's really developed into something special. So I hope to go there one day. Hey guys, good night. Oh, look. If any of my viewers are from Texas, guess what? I'm repping. I'm representing Texas on my neck. Woo! Excuse me? Oh yeah, Los Lonely Boys are from Texas. Do you have anything else to say regarding your trip to Texas?
Oh, let me see. We had a great time. We're tired, but it was. What the heck?
Is that Los Lonely Boys? It is Los Lonely
Boys. Okay, so. Yes, this we've had a great time. Great, great, great time. We needed more time, but what you gonna do? Good night.
Okay, guys, we're checking out, but before we check out, let me give you a little tour of the room. Okay, this is when you first walk in. Got a little mirror here. Hello, hello, hello. And then our double beds and our little TV area. This connects to a different room. We got the chair in here, a little nice reflecting area, and our great view of a wall. It's all right though, maybe better luck next time. I'm not too sure. We should have been staying up there, but yeah. I gotta say the service here was not the greatest. Just from like the beginning of check-in, check-in was good, but we just kind of had problems after that. So I don't know. I mean, the room's cool. The hotel is really nice. They have a nice pool area. Here is the bathroom. Double sinks. A little TV and the mirror. Makeup mirror. Toilet. Tub is really nice. And so is the shower. There's a little sit-down area and shower. And we're ready to go.
There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only.